Hello, everybody. This is Gregory with How I Lost Over 100 Pounds and Have Kept It Off for 30 Plus Years, where there should be no hesitance in your weight loss and weight maintenance. Today, we're going to continue the Confessions of an Obese Child series and talk about my interactions with the opposite sex. Now, before we begin, if you need help with weight loss, contact me through the Clarity FM link found here in the episode notes. Also, in the episode notes, you'll see links to my website, my podcasts, my books. And if you appreciate my content, please hit the like button right now, post a comment, and if you really like it, make a donation via the PayPal link. All right, so today we're going to talk about girls. Girls were might as well have been an alien species to me growing up. I remember in elementary school just being captivated by them. I did have crushes. Even second grade, I had a crush on a girl, third grade, fourth grade. And, you know, what was the crush? Just looking at them from afar. And remember, I only had brothers. I didn't have any sisters. And I had some female cousins, but they lived in another country. So I didn't really have a lot of interaction with women in general growing up aside from my mother. So in elementary school, before the cliques begin, kind of everyone's nice to each other. I don't remember the women really the girls making fun of me that much. I do remember like the awkward things, like third grade, I vomited on a girl. And then I do remember like Valentine's Day, how everybody had to give everybody a candy and a card. And even then I knew like third, fourth grade that this was, you know, these girls didn't like me, but they felt like they had to. And all through elementary and middle school, I was never invited to parties, or high school for sure, but high school is a little different. I was never invited to parties. I never went to a birthday party. And my mother never gave me birthday parties. When it was my birthday, I was like, okay, Gregory, here's a little cake. Here's a little cake. Now we go wherever restaurant you want. That was my birthday. Middle school, I went to a Catholic school again. It was co-ed. Middle school was even more awkward because, again, you're going through puberty now. Now I really like girls. And I noticed, like, when the guys would make fun of me, I would hear girls chuckling. And I think that hurt my feelings more because I knew guys were going to be guys. There was no way I was ever going to change that. But, you know, you still want to like the girls, impress the girls, and so forth. And so that did break my heart to a certain extent. But I wanted to have a girl like me. But I also knew that that was never going to happen. And that was leading to self-loathing, which was leading to eating. I did have a friend named Joyce. And Joyce was, like, just a sixth grade girl in my class. I just distinctly remember, like, she was the only girl who would talk to me, and we would talk like after school while we were waiting to get picked up to talk about like different movies. We both liked John Hughes movies, and this was 1986, so this was like the peak of the John Hughes movies. And we would talk about that and talk about different TV shows, and it was just nice to have a girl to talk to, even though she didn't see me in any way, shape, or form as like a romantic interest at all. She was probably dreaming about Kirk Cameron or Andrew McCarthy or somebody like that. But it was nice to talk to somebody. I do remember distinctly in middle school, we had a graduation dance at the cafeteria, and the entire time I was in the bathroom. It was just too awkward. I didn't want to be at the party. I didn't want to be around anybody, the guys and the girls, or the, you know, I don't know if I made the connection, like these girls wouldn't even ask me to dance. You wouldn't have to worry about dancing because, you know, at that age, you're just very awkward about dancing. But you remember, I smelled the high heaven. I smelled like a combination of feces and baby powder. And then like with imposter's cologne. So I didn't really want to be around women, but at the same time, I didn't want to, what are you doing here, fatty, you know, from the guy. So I just stayed in the bathroom the entire time, and my parents picked me up, and I hated the whole entire experience, kind of like pretty much every other experience I talked about. Now in high school, I went to an all boys high school, but right across the way from the parking lot was the all girls high school. And in high school, I was just getting fatter and fatter. And the good news was that I didn't have to be in class with any girls. That was nice. It would have been better had I not been in class with anybody. That would have been better, but at least the girls weren't around. But I would, like, again, and when I was younger, I would look, like, at lunch or before school or after school, waiting to get picked up, or later when I had a car, just look across the parking lot at the girls and just, you know, what are they like? I like their uniforms. Oh, that one's pretty. But I was under no idea or delusion that I was ever going to have a girl. At this point, you know, I'm 280. And I never interacted with any of those girls pre-weight loss. Now, these girls post-weight loss, because I lost my weight beginning at the end of my junior year, the beginning of my senior year. So my senior year, I was regular weight, Gregory. And so then I did start having experiences, which we'll talk about in future episodes. But overweight me, no. I mean, there was no concept of game. I know game clearly. And the thing is, like, I was certainly what they would call today a blue pill kind of simpy guy. I pedestalized women because I didn't have any women in my life. I wanted a girlfriend, of course. I wanted to be loved. I wanted to be like the end of Pretty in Pink and kiss Molly Ringwald. You know, I was definitely a romantic. And like all these things that I wanted. But I made the realization at that point, as I've mentioned many times at the podcast, is why would these girls have a crush on me if I didn't have crushes on fat girls? My crushes at the time were Alyssa Milano and Elizabeth Shue and regular weighted actresses. Debbie Gibson later on, I really liked. Oh, that was a little before Debbie. Debbie Gibson was more middle school. So, I mean, even then at that age, I understood that there was a massive contradiction because you want to believe as like a blue pill, kind of naive simp, like they'll love me for my heart or my good personality. First of all, I don't even know if I had a good personality. Secondly, this is what you want to believe when you have no external good appearances or a game. You want to believe that the girl's just going to knock on your door. I love you the way you are. Like how somehow Jonah Hill gets, you know, relationships in his movies. But that's just not the way of the world. And I realize, well, look, I can't be mad at women or girls for not liking me because I don't like fat girls. So why would they like fat guys? And I made that realization. So unlike some of the grudge I had maybe with, as I talked about with my brother and my parents, I didn't really have a grudge toward the women because I realized I was a fat piece of crap, smelled strange, and was not attractive. So there was no reason a girl would see me from across the parking lot and be like, he's the one I want. Come on. Guys, post in the comments. Let me know if you can relate to this. Hit the notification, subscribe, and share button. Until next time, take care. God bless and pray.